what this is, that, you know, we're going to have it in the commons and up here on the stage. And to myself, I'm thinking, well, it shouldn't really say that we're going to present from the former wrestling facility. I mean, this is where the 98 team won, right behind the curtain here. You can pull it back. The wrestling mats were there. So it was exciting, you know what I mean? I think that brought something special to our team, as much as, you know, the great facility they have now. I think back to those memories created here in that transition time. Thinking of the blue mats and a yellow hand-painted circle so that we could actually, like, have it out of bounds, I guess, as opposed to a floor. You know, a rope in the stage to climb and to run races through the building. And I think at one point we had a white tape line, like a leopard side and a non-leopard side, if I remember right. Wrestling, unfortunately, you pick up some skin, for those in the know, some skin things, and there was a few people that had to go to that side of the mat. Everybody else, you know, it was free reign, and if you came over, we were going to point that out. Get to your side of the mat. I won't name names as to who was on which side. You know, to set this up, I'd like to go back, you know, when I came in as a freshman, came here, you know, there wasn't much of a program, and I remember writing in English paper in ninth grade English down the hall, talking about dream, you know, I think it was probably on, you know, what's your dream, and I talked about us winning state team titles together as a wrestling program. And I remember, I think I had to draw a picture of what was going on, and what I remember about it is that the wrestler, whoever had it, got a little cut on their arm, and they were bleeding, but it wasn't red, it was black and green. They were bleeding school colors. That's what I remember about that. And it seems crazy to me that I wrote that, or was thinking that, not now, obviously, but back then, because the first meet I remember going to as a freshman, we went to a tri-duel at Schuyler, and we won. We won the duel, but the excitement from the team, maybe not as freshmen, but the team, was as if we had won the state championship. They were jumping up and down and going crazy, and it was just a duel. We beat Schuyler. But that, well, why are we so excited? Like, why are we so, well, we've never won. Oh, well, why am I writing papers about winning state championships? And that gives me credit and thanks to, you know, Coach Hildebrand and Coach Neve, because they had the vision way back when. And if anything, I just give us credit for being pliable and moldable and gullible, you know, to go out and do what they asked, to, you know, on Black Flag Day. If you don't know what Black Flag Day is, it's some crazy thing that they dreamed up where you walk into practice without knowing, and there's going to be a black flag up, and that just means you're going all out for, back then it was supposed to be an hour. We'll start a clock, it'll just be an hour. And everything was 100%. You know, it was supposed to be, whether you were running down the halls or wrestling, it was, you're going all out. And even when you were changing your shoes, you're supposed to change them as fast as you could. Things like that, you know. But we were going hard, and we were sold out for it. You know, that first season, my freshman year, we ended 13th in the season, you know, which was a good year. We had a state champ, the first state champ, Casey, and it was an, you know, that was exciting, but I don't know, why, how did the next year come about? You know, how did we get there? And I think it's, you know, setting goals. I do remember, you know, setting goals at the beginning of the year and being in there, what's our goal going to be, and, you know, setting out the goal to be a state championship team. And, you know, the ironic thing was, our sophomore, we set that as a goal, and I remember vaguely throwing that out as an idea my freshman year, that our goal, write it down, we're going to be state champs, and kind of got laughed at, except for I remember RJ making the deal that he would let us shave his head, and I think any, like, we could shave him if we won the state championship, which sounded good, But that was our freshman year. Our sophomore year, we tried to like, okay, let's do that deal again. No, we're not going to do that deal. You had your chance last year to do that. So obviously he had something in the back of his head, I guess, you know, or couldn't think of a way to probably change the rules later on. So he just thought he'd be good with what he was at. You know, that year was exciting, and it started, you know, I think, catch on with the student body. We wrestled Gross. Duel here in the gym. Gross was the four-time defending champs. They were the team. You know, they had an 89 match win streak going in duels, or they hadn't been beaten. And we, you know, had going back and forth. And for us, it was, you know, obviously Philip Duel, and this was before we were nobody. And we had a large student section for it, which I think was exciting, something that not a lot of high school, I mean, I still follow high school wrestling, you know, you don't have that, you know, that commitment from student body. And they were there, and they came down to the last match, and I think we were down by a couple points, like 3 points, and Alex Mohanna finally put down the suitcases, right? So he's putting the suitcases around, you know, Alex, right? They're just scaring the pigs around. Kind of put down, and he pinned his kid in 30 seconds, it felt like. But and the student section rushed out onto the mats and went crazy for us, and we're jumping around, and I was in a panic that we were gonna lose like team points, and so I was like, get off the mat, get off the mat. Thing, but we won, and you know, and it just went on from there. You know, we go into the state tournament, and you know, Brad kind of told the story as far as coming down to those final matches, and it was all a lot of fun, a lot of hard work, a lot of fun. I think we were in the right place a lot of time. We had that vision. You know, another thing I point out, like with that hard work, I think we had the vision for hard work, and it's how do you create that? You know, so it's easy to maybe take an easy way out. I remember picture day. I don't know if you remember, like, where you go and get your team pictures and your individual pictures. And going down to take pictures, and it was taking too long. Like, that's just the process takes long. And where we turned around and we said, no, we're not doing team pictures. Like, you gotta come back a different day because we gotta get to practice. And so we didn't take a team picture to my, you know. And so the picture that they have there, or like, you know, you see, that was actually taken, if I remember right, after the season, like after we had won the state championship, like when the spring sports were getting their pictures taken, that's when we did our picture that year, because during the season, like, we're here to work hard, and our goal isn't really to get a picture, like, I don't know, I mean, maybe my mom probably wasn't happy about that, and, I don't know, we'll take care of that later, and, you know, I'm glad we did that, you know, maybe that one day, that one practice was the difference, but. We had a lot of fun together, close friendships, you know, even coming back now, I feel like can kind of pick up where you left off talking to these guys, and that, you know, if I need anything, we would do anything for each other. You know, Valentine got a lot of things back. I remember Stuart, you know, was there, you know, we just a close friendship that, you know, guys coming back from Valentine, they're together, spend the night with their parents, three of them in a room together, and they don't want to leave one guy out, so they push the two beds together so that they can sleep three across in the two beds, and so nobody gets left out, they have to be the one thing. I mean, that's the friendships and bonds.
Nick was the meat.
So the bonds that they created, you know, we wanted to be there for each other and have a great time. But at the, you know, I had the big line that, you know, I was confident that we were going to win that state championship, and even more so after I remember winning the state championship, and you go into the tunnel at the time when it was the Devaney Center, and they had already had a handful of shirts that said, you know, state champions on it, and so I didn't know that, but they, you know, gave us the shirt, and I remember, you know, being interviewed by Omaha World Herald and all these different places, and, you know, what do you think, and telling them, We're a wrestling school, you know. You're gonna go into walk into the sky, and you're gonna see banners, and you're gonna know that that's what we're about, and we're gonna, you know, continue to win state championships. And, you know, maybe that's easy to say after we won one. But you know, certainly now, I don't think necessarily I envisioned 20 state championships or however many they have now, or we have now here. But I was confident at that point, like we're started, and it's just, you know, start Dynasty, and we're going to win over and over. But if anything, as I look back now with all those state championships, I would say that I was wrong. You know, as I get the quarterly magazines, the Legacy, we're not just a wrestling school. I mean, certainly that's part of it. We have excellence in everything. You know, it's neat to see all the state championships and all the different programs, whether it's, you know, sports or music or debate teams and, you know, different teams that weren't even here when I was here. And that's exciting to be part of, to be part of something even bigger than I could imagine as part of the wrestling team. So I thank you for, you know, that opportunity. I thank my parents and everyone's parents. It was a lot of fun with them. I think that closeness and bondness that, you know, we had as a team wasn't just us team members. It was our families, all as one, had a great time. And the memories we made, both wrestling, but just in the wrestling room or whatever, are, you know, ones that I'll cherish forever. So I thank you for this opportunity. Honor myself.
Okay. At this time, what we're going to have is Brad's going to, we're going to have every wrestler pass in front of the podium, and we have a memento for every wrestler. They're going to get a wrestling book as well as a medal, a Hall of Fame medal with a base that Bill Howard built that they can put on their desk. So at this time, I guess that Brad will come over. And if the guys could just pass in front of the podium one by one and get their medal. But again, 98 team, amazing. Amazing start for all of them.